Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And in today's video, we're going to take a look at the sectors which are strongest right now and the stocks that are in my watch list from those sectors, the strongest ones, and the stocks which are strongest amongst those sectors that we are going to select today. And we're going to take a look at my watch list. So before starting the video, standard disclaimer, I'm not a SEBI registered analyst and any stock discussed here is not a buy or sell recommendation. Please consult your financial advisor before taking any trade or making any investment. So as we discussed in last week's video, that the market is currently not in a very good state, and there was the very important event also, the budget, which was on the 1st February. And till then, the volatility was very strong. As you can see here, look at these candles. The market fell before the budget, and after the budget, market stabilized a little and went a little bit above. And it also crossed this important resistance of 17,600. As you can see, we're talking about the Nifty 50. So it crossed this important resistance of 17,600. But right now, the structure does not look that strong to me, so I'll be a little cautious and will go for the sector specific and stock specific approach. So as for the Nifty, as we discussed in last week's video, the structure is still that of higher high and higher low. As you can see here, that of higher high and higher low, this low here. So right now, and as we discussed, that this support of 16,400 is very important. So as long as this is not violated, I don't think so there's much to worry about. But there is not enough strong momentum on the upside, so I'll just wait for Nifty to catch a little bit of momentum, because right now it's pulling back a little. It can go this way, or maybe it can go this way also, we don't know about that. So I'll be just going for the sector specific approach. So now let's take a look at the other sectors also. So as we discussed in the last week's video, that the banking and autos look strong. So as you can see here, the bank Nifty didn't fell as much as the Nifty last week. As you can see here, the pullback is relatively smaller, and it also bounced back a little bit better. And right now it is taking support at this resistance, that was the previous resistance, level of 38,790. So, 38,850 was the resistance that is now acting as the support. And prices right now in the formation of higher high and higher low, that is a very good thing. So, I'll be watching the bank Nifty and the financial sector right now, and even in the long term, if you can see. Not the long term, but if you see the broader trend also, the bank Nifty is moving in a parallel channel, and it bounced back from the bottom of the channel, the lower boundary. And once it crosses this level of all time high level of 41,850, I'm expecting it to go around 44,000. But for right now, this level of 38,850 is important, which is acting as a support, and the structure right now is relatively better than the Nifty. So I'll be focusing on the banks and the financial sector. If we take a look at the IT sector, as you can see here, IT sector fell very drastically. As you can see, look at the size of the candles, and it took support here, this boundary, the lower boundary that we had marked before, because this was an important support zone previously also. Like, this was the support zone before during this consolidation, this whole region. And right now, Nifty IT directly fell to this level and bounced back a little. But I won't say the trend is strong and there's a reversal, because right now, although the formation has turned to that of higher high and higher low, as you can see here, this candle with long lower wick from the support zone showing some sign of strength. But as of now, I'll still stay away from IT, because the structure is not really good. I would like to focus on the charts which are making the all-time high, the sectors which are making all-time high, breaking their resistance, the upper resistance. So for that reason, I'll stay a little bit cautious on IT. So now if we take a look at the another sector that was performing well, that is auto. As you can see here, look at the trend here, and the pullback was relatively very shorter as compared to the Nifty, and right now it's just consolidating in this range, and this level of 11,200 would act as a strong support as we discussed last week, and right now it is acting as a good support. As you can see here, the bullish engulfing candle formation here, a price fell, and next day with similar strength it gained back and took support at this level of 11,200. So I'll be watching the one banks and financial sector. Second is the Nifty auto. Now if we take a look at the pharma is a little bit better as it went below this support of 13,000, but there a little bit of consolidation and reversal as you can see here, and right now the formation is turning to that of higher high and higher low. And again, if this level of 13,000 is not violated, then the structure would turn to that of higher high and higher low, and then I'll be looking at Nifty Pharma. So I'll be tracking this one closely. If we look at the FMCG also did something similar to pharma. It went below this support of 35,650 but bounced back. Look at the bounce back, and right now it's forming a kind of the reversal double bottom kind of a pattern as you can see here, and I'll be watching it very carefully. In case it crosses this level 30,450, then I'll be looking at the FMCG stocks. So right now the momentum is strong in this and it is gaining back a little, so I'll be waiting for it to cross this resistance of 38,450. Mark this level on the chart and then we'll take a look at the Nifty FMCG. Metal was also another sector which was performing relatively well as you can see here. It also fell a little bit less as compared to Nifty and bounced back really well, and now again approaching the resistance level of 5,900, which is a very strong and important resistance, and it was validated 3-4 times it has been validated, and this is a very strong resistance. But the metal sector is right now showing some strength, so I'm expecting it to again cross this level of 5,900. Last time also we discussed that the metal sector is performing relatively well, and you can see here it tried to cross but the overall market fell, and with that this metal sector also fell. So now we are gonna take a look at few stocks that I've selected from these sectors. So first let's talk about from the metal sector. So I've selected this Jindal Stainless Steel from the metal sector. As you can see here, the chart is showing clear strength. As you can see here, look at the trend. The stock is going upward, and if you remember the chart of the Nifty, if you take a look at the Nifty, look how drastically it fell from around 18 Jan to 25 Jan. For five days it fell, almost straight 5 day fall with very wide range candle. If we compare it with this chart, as you can see here, it fell around almost 2 days, and since then it has bounced back, and now it's near its resistance zone of 290, and I'm expecting it to cross this level, and our target would be around this old all-time high resistance of, if we take a look at the monthly chart, this resistance that was formed back in 2008. This would be our price target in case it crosses this level of 2019.80. So right now it's showing really good strength as compared to the Nifty. So I'll be watching this one, and JSL Hisar, it's also similar. Both are going to merge, so both are companies of the same group. So as you can see, it's even stronger than the Jindal Stainless Steel. So I'll be watching this one also because there is no upper resistance and the stock is at all-time high level. As you can see, maybe it can pull back a little bit, and again head higher, but I'll be watching it carefully. So next one is, I forgot about one sector that is doing really well. If we take a look at the Nifty PSU, it is doing even better than the Nifty Private Sector Index, Private Sector Bank Index. So as you can see here, it gave a nice cup and handle, a short cup and handle breakout, and right now it's near the resistance of 3054, and right now it's just taking a little bit big, maybe a short pullback, and this will act as a support that is at 2820, and then it can head higher. So Nifty PSU Bank is performing really well, and few stocks I've selected from this sector. As you can see, one is the Canara Bank. As you can see, similar structure, a kind of a cup and handle pattern type here, and a breakout, and after that you can see the move. It went from around 230 to 270, and look at the volumes. So it's showing strength, and right now it's pulling back a little. So if it pullbacks to this level of 247, that would be a really great opportunity to buy, because it would be ready for this target of around 300 rupees. That is a very big supply zone, as you can see here. During the March 2018 to July 2019, this whole region of 300 rupees acted as a strong resistance. So right now a little bit, I'm expecting a little bit of pullback or a short consolidation, then it can head higher to this level of 300. Next one I've taken from the auto sector, as you can see, the Tata Motors. As you can see, it has just been consolidating in this horizontal range, as you can see here, this horizontal range, and these patterns are relatively very easier to trade, because once it crosses the upper boundary, you can buy the stock as it crosses the upper boundary. So you just have to wait for the breakout, and that's what I'm doing right now. It is in a very good structure. I'll be waiting for a clear breakout above this level of 530, then I'll be looking at this, but till then I'm keeping it in my watch list. Next one is from the financial sector, and this one is the Cholamandalam Finance. As you can see here, it fell last time with the whole bank Nifty and all, and since then it has bounced back, and it again retested its resistance level, and as you can see, a very short consolidation here in this zone. If you look at this rectangle, a very short consolidation, that is a very good sign. Look at the long wicks on the lower side of these candles, and a very nice breakout combined with the volume above this level of 667. So I'll be this structure looks really good, and this looks tradable for around like a short term move for around 700 rupees to 720, because it already has given the breakout, and the whole sector is also in a good structure right now. So next one is the Tin Plate, as you can see, from the metal sector. So last week it gave a breakout from this declining trend line, as you can see here, and went up, and right now it's just giving a short pullback, and this will at the level of 348 will act as a strong support for this pullback, and that would be a great opportunity to add this. As you can see here, look at the long wicks. This is the sign of strength. This is just a normal pullback, that is after a big, as you can see here, after a straight one-sided move, the pullback is expected, that is happening right now, and it is giving a really good opportunity to add towards the target of this level of 444. So next one is the SBI from the PSU Bank Index. As you can see here, it is also trading near its all-time high level, the resistance. That is at 542, and in a broader trend, as you can see here, just like the bank Nifty, it is also trading in a parallel upward channel, and within that we are currently at the near the all-time high level, as you can see here. A short consolidation, that is a very good sign. Once it breaks out, I'm expecting it to go towards the upper boundary of this channel, that is around 620. So that would be a really nice 60-70 points move from here. Once it crosses this, once it gives a close above this level of 542, that too with good amount of volume, then I'll be looking to add SPI. So right now it's in my watch list for this week. And the next one is the Hindalco. It is from the metal sector, as you can see here. 2-3 weeks back it gave a inverse head and shoulder breakout, as you can see here, the head and shoulder formation. It gave a very strong breakout. Look at the size of the candle, it closed at the higher level of the day, and look at the volume that was there during the breakout. And after that you can see the move, and just like what is happening in other stocks like the tin plate, and other one was like JSL, sorry, not JSL, in Canara Bank, and you can see in tin plate a pullback, as you can see here. That is what happened in case of Hindalco. You can see here why I was saying that it is a good idea to add at the pullback. As you can see here, when the trend is strong and your sector is performing well, so every dip is kind of a buy opportunity. And as you can see here, after a nice pullback, it again went starting going upwards, and right now it's going towards its all-time high level of 550. So I'll be carefully watching it. One can kind of add here a little bit of like 25% position. That's how you build the position. First you go with 25%, and once you know that your judgment is right, you can scale in afterwards. So I'll be watching it carefully towards its all-time high level, and in case it gives a breakout, then I'll be consider it to go long. So this was it for today's video, and I hope you learned something. And this is what you should do every week: look at all the sectoral charts, sectoral indices, and within that select the strongest sector, and within that strongest sector select the stocks that are strongest, that are near their high and are in a really good uptrend. So that was it for today's video, and in case you learned something, please consider hitting the like button, and don't forget to subscribe and share. Goodbye, take care.